Hi, my name is Anthony Walker. I'm a Wix design expert and I have been for about 10 years. Now that you know how to fulfill orders, today we're going to talk about building trust. So building trust is really important because it increases sales, it builds customer loyalty, and allows people to just feel safe on your website. Now let's talk about pages and how we can build trust using them. So now let's take a look at the website, The Chef and the Dish. We're going to look at this about page and how it builds trust exactly. As you can see here, you can see an image of the actual merchant. She's talking about herself. She's talking about the types of companies that she's worked with and how she's developed things. And that just really builds a really good reputation and a trust palette to kind of work off of as people look at her website and essentially buy her product or service. Everything that she's been a part of also aligns to exactly who she's looking for and what her users' beliefs will be exactly. So next up, we're going to look at another Wix merchant, Ruby Love. As you can see here on her about page, she actually has everything pretty nice. She kind of built a brand kind of like by love a little bit more. Like you can see women, you can see the things that they believe in. They all appear to be pretty happy, which is essentially what her product does. It kind of builds happiness amongst women for different reasons. And she built the product, you know, because of her daughter. So you can see that the passion is there, the love is there, and she's trying to kind of spread that with other people who also want to experience that type of experience. Now we're going to talk about the importance of FAQs or frequently asked questions. And it's very important that when a user gets to your website, they can find exactly what they're looking for. So now let's take a look at a good example that features FAQs. As you can see here on Abby Space, they actually feature a really nice support page with tons of FAQs for their customers. They have questions like, how do I track my order? How long will my product take to get here? Or how do I cancel or change my order? All of these are really good ways to build trust and answer questions for all of your customers that come to your website. All right, so store policies are very important for trust. It just helps people understand exactly the processes in your business and how everything works, from your return to terms of use to getting things refunded or exchanged. It's very important to make everything super transparent. So Abby Space has a really good example of all the policies in the footer of their website. You can do everything from tracking your order to looking at your shipping and delivery policies, or even looking at refund policies or privacy policies. Testimonials and reviews are very important. It's more important that you add them onto your site in a place that every person can see if they're looking to buy your product. Let's take a look at Amazon, for example. Upon me checking for shirts, I see tons of bestsellers. But if you notice closely, all of the bestsellers have really high reviews, as you can see here. Reviews are very important, especially on sites like Amazon, where you can actually see real authentic reviews from real users and people. It also gives you social proofing that you have to respond to those customers. Being very attentive and responsive to all the reviews show great customer service. So social media is also a really good way to build trust amongst all of your customers. The first thing that you'll do upon going into a website is you'll automatically start to check all of their social media accounts, making sure they're a real business and everything checks out. So when it comes to social, like some of the best social media platforms to choose are going to be like Facebook, Instagram, anything really visually driven are going to help you really build your sales up through videos, through images. Just make sure you're a part of every network that you can possibly be on and just get to people as fast as you can. All right, so now let's talk about how to add social media icons to your website. So what we're going to do is first go to the Wix editor, click Add. Next, we're going to scroll to social and then add a social bar or individual channel. Once it's added to your site, click on the social bar and set all of your links, or you can also even add your own social links or URLs. Now we're going to talk about adding a blog to your website and how it actually helps generate more sales for your online store, which is going to be The Chef and The Dish. And we're going to take a look at how they use the blog to maximize their online sales. So as you can see here, they've taken tons of different recipes and they put them into blog posts. And all of these posts actually can allow you to end up back onto a page where you can read about something else or even book a class about that particular recipe or dish. So now we're going to talk about solid customer service methods and how to actually build really good methods using Wix tools. All right, so first off, we can start by adding like Wix chat to your site, for example, a phone number in the footer, your business address and email. Those are all great ways to show customers and users that you are accessible at any time of day. All right, so keep in mind that building online trust is an ongoing effort. So just keep on doing all of the best practices that we spoke about today, and you'll be on your way to having a really successful online store. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to watch the next lesson.